Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject steam boilers. And this is lecture number 1 on steam boilers. So we are going to discuss the different types of boiler, the classification of boiler and the working of a few low pressure boilers we will discuss in this lecture. Boiler is a steam generator which is a closed vessel made of high quality steel in which steam is generated from water by application of heat. So, boiler is a steam producing device, a closed vessel which is used to produce steam by application of heat. So, the heat is produced by burning fuel like coal, oil and the gas. So, for higher capacity boiler, we are using coal as the fuel. For low capacity boiler, we may use oil or gas as the fuel. So, the classification of boiler, first classification according to the relative position of water and the hot gases. So, there are two types of boiler based on the relative position of water and the hot gases. One is fire tube boiler in which hot gases are flowing through the tubes. For example, Cochran boiler, Lancashire boiler and locomotive boilers, and a water tube boiler, so through which, in which the water is flowing through the tubes. So, water tube boiler, water is flowing through the tube and the hot gases are flowing around the tube. For example, Babcock Wilcox boiler, Stirling boiler and all the high pressure boiler, they are coming under water tube boiler. The second classification according to the axis of the shell, axis of the boiler, this may be horizontal boiler or vertical boiler. Then the third classification according to the method of furnace, so the based on the location of the furnace, whether this may be externally fired boiler or internally fired boiler. So, in the externally fired boiler, the combustion chamber will be outside the boiler shell, and the internally fired boiler, the combustion chamber will be inside the boiler shell. And the fourth classification according to the method of water circulation, so this may be natural circulation boiler or forced circulation boiler. So, in the natural circulation boiler, so there is no pump. So, the water flow occurs because of the density difference. So, it is natural circulation boiler. In the forced circulation boiler, we are using a pump for circulation of the water. And normally the high pressure boiler, higher capacity boiler. So, we use forced circulation. And in the case of low capacity boiler, we are using the natural circulation. And according to the method of air circulation, this may be natural draught boiler or forced draught boiler. So, for the air and the flue gases, flow of air and the flue gases, when the flow occurs by natural density difference, natural, that is called as natural draught boiler. And when we use a fan for circulation of air and the hot gases, then it is called as forced draught boiler. So, natural draught boiler, the flow of air and the hot gases, they occur because of the temperature difference naturally. In the forced circulation, forced draught boiler, the fan is used, fan or blower is used for the circulation of air and the hot gases. And the sixth classification, according to the use of the boiler, this may be stationary boiler or mobile boiler. All the power plant boiler or a stationary boiler, mobile boiler, it is used in the train. According to the operating pressure, this may be low pressure boiler or high pressure boiler. So, the pressure, when the pressure is greater than 80 bar, and this is considered as high pressure boiler. And according to the method of assembly, this may be site assembled or portable boiler. All the fire tube boiler or low capacity boiler or portable boiler. So, higher capacity boiler or water tube boiler, they are site assembled. All the components will be taken to the boiler site and it will be assembled there in the site. That is called a site assembled boiler. So these are all the classification of the boiler, and we will see the working of different types of boiler in this lecture. So the first boiler is simple vertical boiler. You take 1 minute, some 30 seconds time, look at the diagram. Identify the different components in the boiler, different parts in the boiler, and there are some important components called important mountings. One is fusible plug, steam stop valve, steam safety valve, pressure gauge, and water level indicator. They are called as mountings. So, mountings are installed in the boiler for safe operation of the boiler. So, mountings are very important. Without mounting, we should not operate the boiler. And the fusible plug, it is here, just above the combustion chamber. So, this is the firebox or the furnace. So, in the firebox or the furnace, we have the grate. So, grate is the place where the combustion of the fuel is taking place. Combustion of the coal is taking place. So, through the fire hole, we are supplying the coal. And when the coal is burning, coal is burnt and the heat is produced, hot gases are produced, then the remaining is ash. So, normally any coal contains some percentage of ash. For example, the Neyveli Lignite Thermal Power Station, the lignite is the coal, low grade coal, which contains maximum of 50% ash. So, 50% ash means for every kg of fuel burning, for every kg of lignite burning, there will be 50%, roughly 500 grams of ash is produced. So, in a huge power plant, the ash handling is a task, is a big task for the boiler maintenance people. So, the burning of the fuel is taking place on the grate, hot gases are produced, and the hot gases are, they are flowing through the vertical pipe. So, the gases are flowing through the pipeline. So, this is called as fire tube boiler. And the water is stored in the shell. And the water is supplied to the boiler shell. And we have a water level indicator. So, the water level indicator is indicating level of water. It is not only indicating the water level. And in modern boiler, so the water level indicator will send this signal to the boiler operator. So, whenever the water level is decreasing, automatically the pump will be operated and the water will be supplied to the boiler. And using the heat energy here, the water is converted into steam and the steam is collected at the top of the shell, top of the boiler shell. And here we have the pressure gauge, which is indicating the steam pressure. And we have the steam safety valve. So, the safety valve is an important device, which is protecting the boiler from excessive pressure. So, the heat is produced continuously, water is converted into steam continuously, the steam is getting accumulated here. So, because of the steam, collection of the steam at the top of the vessel, the pressure of the steam is increasing, which is indicated by the pressure gauge. At a point where the safety, the pressure of the steam is more than the design value, predetermined value. For example, the boiler is designed for 60 bar pressure. When the steam pressure exceeds 60 bar, automatically the steam safety valve will open and the excess steam will be let to the atmosphere. So, the pressure will be brought back to the safe value. So, it is the use of the safety valve. And steam stop valve. So, there will be steam flow through the stop valve. So, whenever we want to stop, so we have to close the valve so that the steam supplied to the turbine or the engine is stopped. So, through this is the valve. So, through which the steam is supplied to the steam turbine or the steam engine or for some industrial process. So, these are all the devices and how the system is working. And the water is stored in the boiler, the hot gases are produced by burning the coal on the grate, the hot gases are flowing vertically in the pipeline, in the fire tube, and the water around the tube, it is getting heated and converted into steam, and the steam is used for industrial process or power generation through a steam turbine or a steam engine. And this simple vertical boiler, it has a capacity, maximum capacity of 2500 kilograms per hour of steam, operating pressure 7.5 to 10 bar, and it is a fire tube boiler, and it is vertical boiler. So the boiler drum is vertical, so it is called as vertical boiler. So this is a very simple construction to understand the basic principle of working of a boiler. And here we have some mountings. So mountings are installed for safe operation of the boiler. So the mountings, what we have seen there, they are fusible plug. So it is used to extinguish the fire in the combustion chamber when the water level decreases below the specified limit. So water level, when the water level decreases, automatically using the pump we supply the water. Suppose there is malfunction in the system of water supply, when the water level goes below the specified limit, automatically the fusible plug will open and the water will be admitted into the combustion chamber to extinguish the fire. Steam stop valve, to stop the flow of the steam from the boiler to the engine or the turbine. Steam safety valve, to permit the escape of steam when the steam pressure exceeds the specified limit. And the pressure gauge, to measure the pressure of the steam in the boiler drum. Water level indicator, to indicate the level of water in the boiler. And the blow off cock, normally blow off cock as a important mounting. So it is used to drain the boiler water for internal cleaning and inspection. So whenever we want to inspect or clean the boiler, so we have to drain the water. So blow off cock is the device mounting which is used for that particular purpose. And the second boiler is Cochran boiler, and again you take 30 seconds time and look at the various components in the Cochran boiler and you observe the change in the design of the boiler. So we find some improvement in the design and the arrangement. So we find some more additional components here in the Cochran boiler. So we have a blow off cock here, we have the blow off cock, and we have the fire brick lining, and we have the fusible plug and the fire tube. Multiple tubes are here. So we have number of tubes, horizontal tubes, fire tubes through which the hot gases are flowing, and here we have the water level indicator water gauge, and we have a manhole through which a man can enter into the boiler for cleaning purpose and maintenance purpose. And we have a pressure gauge, steam stop valve, steam safety valve, and chimney. This is the smoke box where the smoke is collected. And here again we have the inspection door. By opening the door, a man can enter into the boiler for cleaning and maintenance. And we have the fire hole or charging door through which the coal is admitted into the firebox. And the ash pit we have, and we have the grate. And again, the important mountings are, all the mountings are available here: fusible plug, steam stop valve, steam safety valve, pressure gauge, water level indicator, and blow off cock. All the devices are available. And if you look at the diagram, so this is a vertical boiler again, fire tube boiler. We have multiple tubes, horizontal tubes, fire tubes, and the capacity is 3500 kilograms per hour of steam, and the pressure maximum of 10 bar. And the operation of the boiler, so we have to consider two important fluid. One is water enters and water is heated and converted into steam. Another one is air enters, the combustion is taking place, hot gases are formed, the hot gases are flowing through the fire tube and leaving through the chimney. So air and the gas flow and water and the steam flow. So these two are the important flow circuit. So when you explain the flow of air and the gases and water and the steam, that is what the working of the boiler. And you have to explain, name the important mountings, and you have to mention the function of each mounting in the boiler. So for example, fusible plug, it is used to extinguish the fire when there is excess of heat or low water level in the boiler. Steam stop valve, to stop the flow of the steam to the turbine from the boiler. So to regulate the flow of the steam from the boiler to the steam engine or the steam turbine. Steam safety valve, to escape the steam, excess steam, so that we have to maintain the safety pressure, I mean the pressure of the steam to a safer value. Pressure gauge, it is a device which is indicating the pressure. Water level indicator, it indicates the level of water in the boiler. And blow off cock, it is used for draining the water when during the inspection and maintenance time. And regarding the working of the boiler, you can write, so through the fire hole, the coal is admitted onto the grate. The combustion of the fuel is taking place on the grate. The hot gases are formed. So the hot gases from the firebox through the flue pipe, it is flowing, and we have horizontal tubes. So through the multiple horizontal tubes, the gases are flowing horizontally from the left side to the right side, and they are collected in the smoke box, and from the smoke box, it is leaving to the atmosphere through the chimney. And when the hot gases are flowing through the fire tube, the water around the tube, they are heated up, and the steam is formed. The steam is collected at the top of the boiler shell, and the steam is taken from the boiler shell to the steam engine or turbine through the steam stop valve. So it is a continuous process. Continuously water level is indicating, and when the water level is going below the determined level, automatically the water will be admitted into the boiler. We have to maintain a constant level of water in the boiler. So this is Cochran boiler. Next boiler is Lancashire boiler. So far we have discussed simple vertical boiler or Cochran boiler. They are vertical boiler. Now Lancashire boiler is a horizontal boiler. So you look at the boiler drum, it is horizontal. You take 20-second, 30-second time, observe the arrangement of the Lancashire boiler. So there are three views. So the front view of the boiler, top view of the boiler, and the side view of the boiler. And you have the horizontal drum, horizontal boiler shell. All the mountings are available here. You look at here, pressure gauge, steam stop valve, manhole, and high steam, low water safety valve. And we have the fire grate and the flue pipe, the pipe through which hot gas are flowing. It is again a fire tube boiler. And we have the water level indicator and blow off cock here. And here, the hot gases. So similarly, in the top view, you can see the horizontal drum, and in the side view, you can see the drum, and we have two pipes at the center. So two main flue pipelines. And regarding the working of the Lancashire boiler, so the coal is admitted here on the grate. The combustion of the fuel is taking place on the grate using the atmospheric air, which is rushing to the combustion chamber. So the burning leads to the hot gases. The hot gases, first they are flowing in the horizontal main fluid tube. So there are two main fluid tubes. The gases are flowing from left side to right side, and on the extreme right side they are taking a turn, and it is flowing through the bottom of the shell. That you can look at here. So in the top view, there are two horizontal tubes. So it is flowing, and it reaches here and goes under the drum. So below the drum, so that is called as bottom flue. Now the hot gas are flowing from the right side to left side, and once again reaching the fire brick construction and the left side, then it is again taking a turn and flowing again from the left side to right side on the side flue. So first on the main flue inside the boiler drum, then at the bottom of the boiler drum, and in the side of the boiler drum, that you can see in the side view. So the gases are flowing on the inside the boiler, bottom of the boiler drum, and side of the boiler drum. In the three flows, three flows, the heat from the hot gases are transferred to the water to convert water into steam. So the construction, it is little complicated comparing with the earlier boiler, but it is of higher capacity. So we can produce 9000 kilograms per hour of steam. Pressure of maximum 16 bar. This is horizontal bar, horizontal boiler, and fire tube boiler. And the other devices like pressure gauge, safety valve, and the high steam, low water safety valve. So this is a special type of the safety valve. So the safety valve will operate, will safeguard the boiler for two parameter. One is high steam and low water. When the water level decreases below the determined value, so the safety valve will give a warning to the boiler operator by escaping the steam. And similarly, when the steam level is very high, steam pressure is very high, again the water, the safety valve will give the warning to the boiler operator by opening the valve and allowing the steam to flow to the atmosphere. So the other operating, the blow off cock, it is used for draining the water during the inspection time. And water level indicator, as we know, it is used for indicating water level in the boiler. So this is Lancashire boiler, a horizontal boiler, fire tube boiler of maximum capacity, maximum pressure 16 bar and capacity of 9000 kilograms per hour. And the next one boiler is locomotive boiler. And locomotive boiler, the name may be familiar to you. So this is the boiler, this is the boiler used in the train. Earlier, when the train were operated using the steam power, so we were using locomotive boiler in the train. You may find a big black color horizontal drum at the front side of the train. That is what the boiler. So the locomotive boiler. And this is maximum pressure of 14 bar, capacity of 9000 kilograms per hour, and this is again horizontal boiler and the fire tube boiler. You take some 20 seconds time and observe the arrangement and the various parts in the boiler. So the various components in here, we find the horizontal fire tubes, and we have the grate, and we have a fire bridge arch, and we have fire hole through which the coal is admitted, and water level indicator. We have the superheater. So this is the additional component here, superheater, which is inserted in the fire tube, and we have the steam dome, where we have the regulator. By pulling the lever, we can allow the steam to escape, and we have the safety valve, and we have the flue gas through a nozzle, it is leaving to the chimney, and this is the smoke box, and here we have, this is the blast pipe, and through this we are admitting the steam for producing pressure difference. This is called a steam jet draught. This is exhaust steam from the steam engine, they are admitted here, which will induce the flow. So that is called as the induced draught fan using the steam jet. So we admit the steam here for making the effective flow of the flue gases and the air in the boiler. And we have the blow off cock, and the air is admitted here, and at the bottom of the combustion chamber or the furnace we have the ash pit. And here we have the damper, it is again a door for admitting the air. So on both sides we have the damper for admitting the air. So the damper will be automatically opened and closed because of the pressure difference. And how the system is working? So the coal is admitted through the fire hole on the grate. The combustion of the coal is taking place on the grate. Hot gases are produced. So the air is admitted. So air for combustion is admitted at the bottom. So the combustion of the coal is taking place. Hot gases are produced. The hot gases are flowing through the firebox and then through the horizontal fire tubes from right side to left side. As the gases are flowing through the fire tube, the water around the fire tube, they are heated and the steam is formed. The steam is collected at the bottom top of the shell. The hot gases leaving to the on the right left side, and they are collected here, and from the through the nozzle and the flue gas pipe, they are leaving to the chimney to the atmosphere. So here we are, there is no tall chimney. So this is actually locomotive boiler is used for mobile type of boiler. So we do not have the tall chimney. So to create the pressure difference, we have a nozzle. So the nozzle will create the pressure difference for the flow of the hot gases. And the smoke door, it is for opening. So suppose if you want to attend some maintenance work, we can open here and a man can enter for cleaning and maintenance. And similarly here we have a manhole, so through which a man can enter. By opening the manhole, a man can enter for attending the repair or the inspection duty. And in the locomotive boiler, so whenever we want the steam for our external use, in the case of steam engine or the steam turbine, to operate a steam engine or steam turbine, so the lever, we have to pull the lever. So when you pull the lever, the valve will be opened and the steam will be admitted to the superheater. So from the superheater, the superheater steam is admitted from here. So here the opening is here. So the superheater steam to the steam engine. So it goes to the steam engine. And similarly, normally in the train, we may find some whistle. So the whistle is produced by the by escaping the steam. That is also done by the operator by pulling the lever. So when you pull the lever, the steam will go to the superheater. The superheater steam will be taken to the engine. So this is locomotive boiler with a maximum pressure of 14 bar and the capacity of the steam generation capacity is 9000 kilograms per hour. It is a horizontal boiler and a fire tube boiler. And so far we have discussed the four different types of fire tube boiler. And the next boiler is Babcock Wilcox boiler. It is the first water tube boiler we are going to discuss. And look at the construction, take 20 seconds time. And look at the construction and arrangement of the Babcock Wilcox boiler. So here again we have to identify the component. So we have a horizontal drum. So the combustion is not taking place inside the drum. Combustion is taking place outside the boiler drum. And we have the water level indicator, fusible plug, pressure gauge, safety valve, steam safety valve, steam stop valve, and we have a superheater, and we have bundle of tubes. So through the tube water is circulated, and the tubes are connected to the boiler drum. So the water is entering here and flowing through the pipeline. It absorbs the heat energy. The steam is leaving from the, again returning to the boiler drum. So in the boiler drum on the right side we have the manhole and we have the chimney. So through this the flue gas are flowing to the atmosphere through the chimney, and in the pipes, horizontal tubes are connected to the header. So this drum like structure is called as header, and tubes are connected here. And in the left side, right side header we have the mud box. Suppose the water contains some impurities, the impurities are collected after evaporation, the impurities will be collected in the mud box and they are drained out using the blow off cock. And we have the baffle plates. So for deflection of the hot gases we have the baffle plates, and the wall construction brick walls are available to support the fire tube bundle. And on the left side we have the fire door and the grate here, and the ash pit is at the bottom of the grate. So the hot gases are formed on the grate. And we have the inspection door here. So by opening the inspection door, a man can enter to inspect and maintain the boiler. So this is the construction and the working of the boiler. So the mounting operation of function of the mountings, pressure gauge, steam safety valve, steam stop valve, and the fusible plug, water level indicator, blow off cock, the function of the mounting are very much similar. And we just look at the working of the boiler. And the working of the boiler also, I said two circuits. One is air and the gas circuit, another one is water and the steam circuit. So if you explain air and the water circuit and air and the gas circuit, water and the steam circuit, that will give the explanation for working of the boiler. So we take the air and the gas circuit. So the fuel is admitted by opening the fire door. The fuel is admitted onto the grate. The combustion of the coal is taking place here using the atmospheric air, and the hot gas are formed in the combustion chamber or the furnace. The hot gas are flowing vertically in the upward direction, and they are flowing on the left side of the tube bundle, and it is heating the various tubes here, and it is heating the bottom of the boiler drum, and then it is deflected. So So by the boiler drum, they are deflected and flowing through between the baffle plates. So here we have two baffle plates. Between the baffle plates, it is heating the superheater and then the tubes again, and it is getting deflected by the baffle again, and it is flowing through the outside, and then it is leaving to the atmosphere. So hot gases, they are moving up and down for effective heating of the water to convert into steam. The water is stored in the boiler drum, and using the heat energy of the hot gases, the water is heated and converted into steam. So the water actually, it is flowing through the downtake header. So this is the downtake header. So the water is coming here, and it absorbs the heat energy in the tube bundle, converted into steam. The steam, they are going to the uptake header. So from the uptake header, the steam is taken to the boiler drum, and the steam is collected above the water level. And the steam is, whenever you want the steam, whenever we open the steam stop valve, the steam from the boiler drum, it flows through the superheater, and the superheater steam will be admitted to the steam engine or the steam turbine for producing power. So this is the first water tube boiler. Normally high pressure boiler, they are water tube boiler. So the pressure, operating pressure of the Babcock Wilcox boiler, maximum of 100 bar. The capacity is more, 27,000 kilograms per hour. It is a horizontal boiler and the water tube boiler. So this is the working of first water tube boiler, and we have discussed the working of vertical boiler, simple vertical boiler, Cochran boiler, Lancashire boiler, locomotive boiler, and Babcock Wilcox boiler. So we stop here. These are all the books I have published earlier. So design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery, and also YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects for the benefit of mechanical engineering students. So if you like the lecture, you subscribe the channel and use other video lectures for your better learning. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the YouTube comments box, and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. We stop here, and we'll meet again with additional with other topics in the steam boiler in the next lecture.